So now into the box is Eugenio Suarez. He will lead this one off today. Kershaw now on 1-1. Grounded to the right, fielded cleanly. A shuffle over to Kershaw covering to record the out.
Batting second, the first baseman, number 19, Joey Votto.
So one out and nobody aboard. And standing in is the on-base machine, first baseman Joey Votto. And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now. Bases are empty. One man out. And here's one that barely misses off the inside corner. 2-2. Our temperature should get us up into the 70s as we move along. 68 at first pitch. Here now the 2-2.
I got 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Hit back up the middle. He's got it. On to first, and Votto's gone for out number two.
Batting third.
Base is empty, two away. Baseman. And up next, the former World Series hero, Mike Moustakas. And Kershaw can't find the target there as he's run it as far as it can go now. It's 3-2. And that one yanked just foul. Another payoff pitch. On the ground near home. That winds up foul. The 3-2 one more time.
You know, all the pitchers I talked to throughout the course of my career, they always said they wanted to establish the heater the first time through the order. Right there, he kind of took a different route, thrown a nasty changeup.
And he fouls this one off. This is indeed a battle. The 11th pitch coming up. And it's fouled away. And he struck him out as this epic battle goes to the pitcher and the side is finally retired. 1-2-3 go the Reds. The Dodgers coming up and we are scoreless. So that'll bring in Mookie Betts. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2. Into the windup and the pitch. Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now, 3-2.
I can't blame him one bit out on the mound. I'm shocked he didn't pick up the rosin bag and see if he could get a foul ball on that one. He had to see if he would swing way outside the zone.
Oh, right back to him on the mound. And he'll flip on to first to record the out.
Batting second, the first baseman, Matt Muncy.
No one on with one down, and that'll bring up the left-handed hitter Max Muncy. One out, nobody on. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Here he comes again, 1-2. Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
Into the box, Will Smith. Fouled off. Here now the 2-2.
Hey, I know the idea is to try to get the guy to swing on a 2-2 pitch, right? But that one was so low, I don't know anybody that would have swung at that pitch.
And a good job there to lay off. It's ball four as he becomes their first base runner of the ball game now with two away.
Well, the reason power hitters generally draw more walks than other guys is exactly what we saw right there. Pitchers work around them and nibble the corners a lot more so they don't get burned. He made some good pitches, but he just couldn't get him to chase enough out of the zone.
Smith leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. Laid off the bender there, but it's in for a called strike. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. One left for LA. We are still scoreless. Second inning set to go, and the right-handed hitting Nicholas Castellanos will bat next. Now he turns and smokes this one into deep center field. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double.
Wow, not sure what the pitcher was thinking, serving up a fastball right over the heart of the plate. His eyes got as big as saucers as he blasts this thing, putting himself into scoring position to start off the inning.
Into the box now, Tucker Barnhart. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1. Dero, Danny, this L.A. Dodger ball club, as they enter play here this afternoon, all you can really say is they've been on one heck of a run.
Hey, thanks, Matty V. Hey, Dero, we've got a couple of teams playing some good baseball right now. Unfortunately, a winning streak for one of these teams is going to end today, but, boy, this is a great matchup here.
Yeah, I'm excited to call this one with you two guys, definitely. The two teams playing top of their game right now, really playing well. Both come in on winning streaks. We're going to see who's able to execute in this one.
Here now the 2-2. Chopped weakly to the left. He's set. Here's the 2-2. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
You can certainly tell at-bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher. But you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Now the 3-2 pitch, and he misses there for ball four. So runners are at first and second now with nobody out.
Well, that was a slider in a 3-2 count, and it just didn't tempt him enough to get a good swing. A good job of pitch recognition and knowing the strike zone to draw the free pass there.
Next to hit, Jesse Winker, and he's definitely off to a fast start in the early part of the season. Ready with the 1-1. Oh, and he was fooled that time on the pitch away as he went around for strike two. None out, runners at first and second. And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2.
Yeah, and if you get a guy flailing at a pitch like that, heck, you're going to go out there and throw that same pitch till he proves he can lay off of it.
There's a shin-high slider laid off for a ball. Nick Senzel is on deck. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone. So first and second with one down, and that means Nick Senzel will dig in at the plate. And he misses with it, ball four, so that'll load the bases, and now he's really going to need to get a ground ball.
Well, this guy's been prone to giving up walks and bunches, and that's already two walks here in the early going. We'll see if this continues to be an issue for him as this start continues.
Next up will be Kyle Farmer, and he's looking to get it going, off to a bit of a slow start this year. Hit down the third baseline, gloved by Turner. But the throw pulls him off the bag as he can't get a foot back in time, and the run will score. So you can mark that one down as an E5, and I'd bet he'd like to have that one over. Bases full now following the error, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Sonny Gray. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball. And a strike three called. My gracious, what a pitch with the bases loaded, and there are two away now. So it's back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in Eugenio Suarez. The 2-2 fouled away. Again, another foul ball. Two and two. Here it is. Got him. So the damage winds up not being as bad as it could have been, as they'll strand the bases loaded. This side is retired. So one run on one hit, one Dodger error, and three men left stranded. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two. It's the Reds 1 and the Dodgers nothing. Last half of the second set to go, and stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Corey Seager. The 1-1 home. And he fouls this one off. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by, brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
Stepping in now, Chris Taylor. Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Two up, two down on strikes in this inning. He looks really sharp out there, guys.
Center fielder, AJ Pollock.
At the plate now,
AJ Pollock.
2-2 now with two away and the bases empty.
We just saw a fastball right there. I would not be shocked if he tries to get this guy to go fishing right here and drops a little off-speed pitch in the dirt.
And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Welcome back to Dodger Stadium. Let's send it down to the field and Heidi Watney.
Matt, I had a chance to talk about the state of the Reds' offense with their manager between innings.
And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
Yes, they've only scored one run, but he said they've done a great job of forcing the pitch count up, and he thinks that's going to lead to more offense for them as this game goes on.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Top of the third set to get underway, and set to go is the veteran first baseman, Joey Votto. Now the 3-2 pitch. Grounded softly to the right, reined in. A shuffle over to Kershaw covering to record the out. And with one gone in the inning, let's give you a look at the current standings in the National League West entering play as you see where the Dodgers find themselves in the division race. Next to stand in is Mike Moustakas, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch.
Three ball, one.
Nicholas Castellanos is on deck. Swung on and missed.
When you get yourself to a 3-1 count and you get a fastball, those are the ones you really want to punish. Couldn't get the bat on it, so we'll see if that comes back to haunt him.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Swung on and chopped up the middle. Fielded cleanly. Throw on to first to take care of him, and Kershaw is in control now, two away. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Nicholas Castellanos. He scored a run after stroking a double in his first at bat. Now the 1-2 pitch from Kershaw. Line drive to left. Taylor will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Reds are down in order, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Bottom of the third now, and up next will be Gavin Lux. The 1-1.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence, he's got great body language on the mound, he's got fastball command, and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
The 2-2. Swing and a miss. Five straight strikeouts now, and there's one gone.
Man, they've really had his number so far in this series. That's his fifth strikeout in this series alone.
Kershaw.
Standing in now, Clayton Kershaw. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. And it's fouled away. Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
Count remains full. Fouled off. Another full count pitch home. He swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Boy, this guy has really good stuff so far on this one. How about 7 Ks and we're just in the middle innings of this one. If he continues this up, this could be a real solid performance.
So now to the plate, Mookie Betts. 2-1 now to Mookie. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
This is a good at bat so far here with two away. If you're going to go down 1-2-3, at least make the guy work for it. He's doing that, and he's even gotten himself into a good hitter's count now.
Adi somehow gets that one by him, 3-2 now.
This lineup is flailing right now. They're having a hard time just making contact, let alone putting the ball in play.
Sent in the air out to straightaway center. Senzel makes the play, and the side is retired. Dodgers down in order. They still trail 1-0. All set for the start of the fourth, and that'll bring in the veteran catcher Tucker Barnhart. Kershaw now on 1-1.
That's a ball.
Time to wake up the offense right here. 3-1 count, all in on something over the heart of the plate.
And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
That leadoff walk is a great way to start this inning when you're looking to pad the lead. Could be the beginning of good things here in this half inning.
And stepping in, Jesse Winker. First time up, he went down looking.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in the setback.
Now the 1-1 pitch. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two. Fouled away.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating, feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
Again, he sends it out of play. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And he fouls this one off. Barnhart aboard here at first with nobody out. And it's fouled away. He'll try again, 1-2. Swung on and missed. Really fooled him that time for the first out.
That strikeout was a real good example of a pitcher continuing to make a guy chase out of the zone. When you recognize a hitter is in protect mode, you don't have to come inside the strike zone. You can just expand further and further until he literally can't touch it.
Into the box, Nick Senzel. 1-2 now.
Hey, you know the pitcher right now. He's looking for that best friend, that double play ball. This is where you have to really be disciplined at the plate and make sure that you get a pitch that's above the knees that you can get in the air.
Late making contact on that swing, and will do it again on 1-2. And he got him.
Boy, that's really disappointing for a guy that has wheels, right? All he wants to do is get on base and take advantage of the strength of his game, which is his speed. But with a strikeout right there, you can't get on first base if you strike out.
In now, Kyle Farmer. Filthy changeup that time, but he's able to make contact and he'll get another chance. The 3-2 one more time. Skied into straightaway right. Betts has a read on it, and the inning is over. One left for Cincinnati, but they're on top 1-0. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth, and that'll bring up the big bat of Max Muncy.
Still a big bagel in that hit column, and this is where the frustration can start setting in on a team if they're not careful. It's never a good feeling when you know the guy out there on the mound is completely shutting you down.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And he just misses inside with the fastball there.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
Fouled off. Looking to punch him out again. The pitch. And he jumps on this one. It's high and deep to center. And he's going to make the catch on the warning track. A fine running play there for the first out. One gone now in the Dodger fourth. And that brings up Will Smith. Now the 1-1 pitch is taken for ball two. Dodgers have yet to break into the hit column here. This is on the ground over to first. Fielded by Votto, and there are two away now.
Now batting, the third baseman, Justin Turner.
That's a hit, the first in this game for the Dodgers.
No mistake what he was sitting on, looking for a dead red piece of cheese middle of the plate, and he didn't miss it.
Corey Seager.
To the plate now, Corey Seager. A ball and two strikes. Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. And that one got a piece of him.
Well, he's really been good all game long until that one. He was definitely not trying to hit a guy when he's got two strikes on him. It just appeared that it got away from him.
Next up, Chris Taylor trying here to plate the tying run from second. Ready with the 2-1. 3-1.
He drilled the previous batter, and now he falls behind 3-1 to this guy. The last thing you can do, though, is throw a fastball middle of the plate right here.
Yeah. 3-1. Here's the pitch. And that pitch misses for ball four. So some intrigue now as the bases are loaded here with two away.
I think he was trying to be a little too fine there, and a walk is the result. Well, the good news is he has a force at every base. The bad news, a single probably drives in a couple of runs.
Now at the plate, A.J. Pollock, a potential tying run for him at third base. Oh, and it misses ball four, and that will force home a run.
And this inning is a perfect example of how quickly fortunes can change in this game. He was cruising along, hardly any trouble at all. Now he walks in a run and is still in the middle of a bases loaded mess. He's got some work to do to limit the damage.
So our situation has the bases loaded, two men out, and up next will be Gavin Lux. The set and the 1-1 fouled away. The set and the 1-2.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
The set and the 2-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
The payoff pitch. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. I'll give the enthusiasm a 10, the dancing a 4. No shame, and you gotta love it. More matinee baseball here on a Wednesday afternoon following this. Now to the plate, the pitcher, Sonny Gray, comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Now the Dodgers get a right-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. Down the left field line and deep. Two and two count. Here it comes. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
He showed right there why having a good changeup is so valuable. Two and two, and he flips one up there that the bottom really falls out at the last minute. It's so hard to pick up, and it's even harder to make good contact with.
At the plate now, Eugenio Suarez. Over at the knees, and that's the second strike. Really feels like he's just on cruise control out there on the mound right now.
Boy, this is a tight one. You kind of get the feeling like the next team that scores is going to win this one.
Two-two pitch is fouled away. Into the windup and the pitch. And another foul ball. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. And Kershaw can't find the target there as he's run it as far as it can go now. It's 3-2. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk. One out, runner at first, and standing in is the on-base machine, first baseman Joey Votto. And he fouls this one off. Suarez, base runner at first with one out. And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on balls.
Up next to Cincinnati, the second baseman.
Now here's the Dodgers skipper up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And he's going to make a move, as that's going to be all for his starter this afternoon. So he'll depart in the fifth with the go-ahead run on base. Didn't work the required five for the win, but he could still be hung for the loss should that run come around to score. Jimmy Nelson takes the mound to try to get out of this mess. There are two on with only one away. Mike Moustakas will be his first assignment here, as he'll face him with runners at first and second and one gone. He's set, and the 1-2 pitch.
Number three hole hitter up right now. Cleanup guy on deck. Two ball, two strike count. I think pitcher wants to make something happen right here.
A swing, and he pops him up on the infield, and the infield fly rule will be in effect here. So now the Reds cleanup hitter, Nicholas Castellanos. And we'll see what he can do here with a pair of runners on base and two gone here in the fifth. And he grooves the fastball there. This is hit high and deep out to straightaway center field. Now a leaping effort at the wall, but he comes up empty. This one is gone. Home run. So a three-run blast to deep center here. Eighth home run on the season for him, as the Reds have opened up a 4-1 lead.
Man, you could see the center fielder tracking the ball the entire way. He thought he had it, and he might tell you he should have had it, but he just couldn't bring it back into the yard. Sometimes it's a game of inches, folks.
Stepping in now, Tucker Barnhart. And he strikes him out here, so he's able to stop the bleeding a bit as the side is retired. But the big blow of the inning comes right here, a three-run home run. On to the bottom of the fifth. It's now 4-1 Reds. Welcome back to Dodger Stadium. Let's send it down to the field and Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together.
They've already worked out three walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
All right, Heidi, thank you. Doug Goudy will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here. And there's ball two now. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Liner towards second. But this will be taken in at second base. Good positioning for the first out.
Now batter.
So one down, no one aboard. And that'll bring up Mookie Betts. Fifth inning here in a 4-1 ball game. Changeup called a strike, and he comes back even at 2-2. And a slurve, but this is in the dirt for a ball.
Looked to me like he tried to do way too much on that 2-2 pitch. You don't have to come into the zone on that count, but a pitch that far outside isn't going to tempt anyone to swing.
3-2 pitch. Loud contact by Mookie, and a ball carrying well to left field. And it's gone! A solo home run there for Mookie. Home run number three here in the early going. And the Dodgers have cut this to a 4-2 score now. Here comes the Red skipper up out of the dugout on his way to the mound. And that's going to be all for Sonny Gray. So he'll head to the dugout after working just 4 1/3, not enough to qualify for the victory, as his bullpen will have to go a long way to hang on to the lead. Carson Fulmer, a right-hander standing 6 foot even, will take over the pitching duties here. At the plate, Max Muncy. Think he held up in time, but that becomes moot as it's a called strike two. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. To two balls and two strikes now. And this is popped up near second base. Farmer has to shade his eyes from the sun, but he stays with it for out number two. And now in the box, Will Smith. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. This pitch is popped up. Votto shading to his right, and the inning is over. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. We're through five here this afternoon. It's now 4-2. Brustar Graterol will come on and make his fourth appearance in this campaign. And now, Jesse Winker. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. The 1-1. Hit in the air out to center field. Pollock on the run. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. Stepping up is Nick Senzel. He went down on strikes in his last at bat.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. And this is swung out and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the sixth inning.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Standing in now, Kyle Farmer. Hit on the ground to short. Scooped up. Throw on to Muncy, gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Reds, but they still lead this one 4-2. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and that'll bring up the third baseman, Justin Turner. Now the 1-1 pitch. Changed up on him as this is grounded to second. Throws in time, and that's out number one. So with one gone, let's take a look at the standings in the National League Central as we see where the Reds find themselves entering play today. So the next to bat will be Corey Seager. Last time up, he was hit by a pitch.
Yeah, Maddie, you're not lying. Last time up, squared right in the back. Hopefully it doesn't stiffen up. I want to see if he can get through something right here.
Two balls and two strikes to Corey Seager. And now a right-hander's begun to loosen up in the Cincinnati bullpen. We're in the sixth inning now of a 4-2 ball game. And it's fouled away. Here's another 2-2. Trying to nibble here, and he misses to run it full now. 3-2.
Right guy, right spot. This is one of the better hitters in their lineup. Just the guy they want to see coming up now to get this inning going.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
Well, we'll see a lot of these power arms coming out of the bullpen in these days, but it doesn't make it any less impressive to me. I love watching guys come in and blow smoke right by guys.
Into the box now, Chris Taylor. And opposite field as he lines this down the line and right. Now this will rattle up against the wall. And he is in the second with a two-out double.
When it left his bat, I thought it might curve foul, but he manages to squeak it just inside the right field line for a well-hit line drive double. By the time the right fielder tracked it down, he was easily into second.
In now, A.J. Pollock. Now a swing as he foul tips it here, and right off his arm behind the plate. That hurts. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Looked like he was a little over-aggressive there to throw that nasty curveball. Just needs to slow his delivery down a bit.
Fouled off.
Hey, if you're going to get a swing on a pitch that far in off the plate, pretty much options are wide open.
He's set. Here's the 2-2.
Some pitchers fall into the trap of giving in on 3-2 because they don't want to walk the guy. But with the base open, it's not the end of the world if you do. You still need to make a quality pitch.
Now the payoff pitch home. Slow grounder to first. Reined in. And nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. So they can't make anything out of the two-out double. On to the back third here this afternoon, and we've got it for you on the show. Tyler Naquin is up off the bench as he'll pinch hit here to start inning number 7. Gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And the pinch hitter is retired here, one away. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Eugenio Suarez, 0-for-2 with a walk for him so far. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. And he misses 2-1.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
Two-one pitch is a fastball swung on and missed 2-2.
This is why you pay the price of admission right here. Power on power. My money's on the pitcher.
3-2, full count. Drive fair ball down the line. Throw into second. And he's able to hustle his way up to second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
Wow, he must be living right because he gets absolutely jammed. Thought we were going to see the bat splintered, but instead he muscles the ball to right for a double. Might get some heckles from his teammates, but no doubt he'll take it.
Into the box, Joey Votto. Just low that time with the heavy sinker as it's ruled ball three.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Count full, three balls and two strikes. Now the payoff pitch home. And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning.
I'm sure the manager is fine with that. He tried to entice him with that 3-2 pitch, but he didn't take the bait. First base was open, though, so he just needs to make a good pitch for a ground ball.
So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out. And up next, the former World Series hero, Mike Moustakas. Swing and a high fly ball out to left field. Back goes Taylor at the track. On the warning track, he makes the catch. Nicholas Castellanos will stand in as he's accounted for one of the biggest at-bats of the game so far. A three-run shot back in the fifth that's really energized his ball club. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2.
Now 2-2, two on, two out. This is when you have to make a pitch right here. The last thing you want to do is run the count full to 3-2. Then the runners are going to be off to the races.
Got him swinging, and that's the third out. Reds strand a couple as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. T.J. Antone gets the call from the pen to take the ball for the home seventh. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Gavin Lux. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. And he can't get out of the way there, so the leadoff man will be aboard to open up the inning.
And this is a case of a pitcher letting his frustrations get the best of him. He feels like he gets robbed on the previous pitch, and he just rears back and really let it go on the next pitch, but it got away from him in a big way.
Matt Beatty will come on to pinch hit here in a big spot. Now a throw over, runners back. In the dirt here. And he is in there. They couldn't get him at second. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Well, when a reliever comes in a game, he always wants to make a big impression. But I don't think uncorking a wild one was what he had in mind. Sometimes it takes a reliever a little bit of time to be comfortable on the mound out there. So we'll see if he can settle in.
The 2-1. Is a sinker that misses for a ball.
This would be an absolute terrible start to the inning. After drilling the first guy, you can't allow the second guy to reach base via the walk.
And he lays off ball four. So he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done.
Wow, I'm not sure what they were afraid of in this at bat. The count moved to 3-2, and they didn't even challenge him there. I can understand being careful with some hitters, but not that guy. He'll happily take the walk.
So it's first and second now. Nobody out. And up next, one of the terrific talents in the game, Mookie Betts.
Well, you don't see this very often, Matty V. A two-strike straight changeup. But this guy changeup is one of the best in the league. We'll see if he tries that different approach this time. And maybe if he gets to two strikes, try to use the fastball a little bit more than that straight changeup.
And this is swung on and missed. And, boy, they took care of a key man there. One away.
The first baseman, Max Muncy.
Thank you. At the plate now, Max Muncy. And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
That's a big strikeout there with the tying run over at first base. Now, with two outs, it becomes a lot more difficult to manufacture that guy home. Probably need a ball in the gap to give him a chance.
Here now is Will Smith. And with men on base and two away, it feels like this at-bat could go a long way toward deciding this thing.
No doubt, Matt. A base hit here changes this game quite a bit. But if they can't score here, it looks pretty bleak for them heading into the last couple of innings.
Lux on second. Beatty at first, two out in the inning. Hard hit ball to second, fielded by Moustakas. On to first, and the Dodgers come up with nothing as that ends the inning. Dodgers strand a couple. They trail it here 4-2. Garrett Clevenger has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth. Now it'll be Tucker Barnhart. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. Now a flare out toward right center. Lux ranging into the outfield. He's there and records the first down. So one away here in the Reds' half of the eighth. And next to bat will be Jesse Winker. Swing and a liner. But quick hands over there at third as he takes it for the second out. Stepping in next, Nick Senzel. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. The 1-1. Misses, ball two. Right-hander starts to loosen out in the bullpen now. Now the 2-1. And a fastball swung on and hit to second. He's right there. Throw to first beats him easily, and the side is retired. Reds are down in order, but they still lead this one 4-2. Lucas Sims is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Bottom of the inning now, and standing in is the veteran third baseman, Justin Turner. Ball and two strikes now. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Swung on and hit pretty well out to deep left field. Not quite out of here. It's off the out-of-town scoreboard. Not in time, and he's in there with a double.
That's what you call a clutch piece of hitting. Down two runs, he puts himself in scoring position and brings the tying run to the plate. We'll see what they do with the base open here. This one's getting interesting.
At the plate, Corey Seager. And that misses 2-1. 2 and 2.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away.
The left fielder, number 3.
Runner at second, one away, and in to hit next, it'll be the ever versatile Chris Taylor. Down low, two balls and a strike. Now the 2-1 pitch. Waves and misses for strike number 2.
Well, that's a surprising late swing on a heater, middle cut right there. In a fastball count, he's going to have to turn it up a notch.
A bouncer to the left side. He's got it. Throw in time at first for out number 2. So a runner at second. Two down now. And up next, the center fielder, A.J. Pollock.
Pollock.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Getting late, 4-2 our score as we play the eighth inning. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Clearly fired up to work out of that jam. More matinee baseball here on a Wednesday afternoon following this. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Blake Treinen will come on now, and he'll slide into the 7th spot in the lineup following the double switch. DJ Peters is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting 9th now on the double switch. The 1-1 home. Misses above the zone for a ball. Now the 2-1 pitch.
That's ball three.
You do not want to walk the 8-hole hitter. It just opens up so many options. Do we bunt them over to second with the 9-hole hitter? Do we try and play for that big rally with the top of the order coming up? This is a huge pitch. You can't allow this guy to walk.
Now a fastball swung on and missed, and it's full 3-2.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
Fouled away.
Yeah, you could tell he was ready for another fastball, but the pitcher went to breaking ball, and the hitter just fouls that one off.
Once again, a 3-2. Ripped down the first baseline. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the 9th inning gets underway. Tyler Stevenson steps into the on-deck circle now, looking to start something here with one gone in the inning. Unable to get the bat around in time, and the count evens at 2-2. Now here it comes. Grounded up the first baseline, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. And the pitch. Another one sent foul.
Hey, 3 foul balls in a row right here, searching for that put away stuff.
The 2-2 one more time. Sent on the ground out to second. Fielded cleanly, and that's the second out. Back to the top of the Reds lineup now, and stepping in, Eugenio Suarez. He's got a hit in 3 at bats to this point.
Oh,
Well off the inside that time as the sinker misses for a ball. Two out, nobody on. Ball three.
There's the heavy sinker right there. What makes that pitch so difficult to hit is not only does it change eye levels, it actually changes plane. You go to hit it at one position, and it's 6 to 8 inches dropping off the table and chasing your hands.
The 3-2 pitch. Hit high and deep out to straightaway left. Back goes Taylor, still going back. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. A solo shot here to left. Fourth home run here in the early going. And just like that, it's now a 5-2 ball game.
They still have the bottom of the ninth to try and stage a comeback. But one thing that's not coming back is this blast to extend the lead to three. Nice knowing you've got some room for error, especially on the road.
To the plate now, Joey Votto. And he fouls this one off. Bases are empty here with two men out. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Now another 2-2 towards second. And that's in for a base hit. Make it a 1-for-3 game so far.
Boy, D-Roll, that ball wasn't hit very hard, but when you're struggling like this guy is, any knock is a good knock.
Yeah, 100%. He doesn't usually get those. He has to square it up mid-barrel to find a way to get a knock. He hasn't had much luck this year, but he'll take that any day.
Standing in now, Mike Moustakas. This pitch is popped up. Turner is there for it. And he's got it for the final out of the frame. But add on one more as the solo shot stretches their lead even further. Last chance coming up here for the Dodgers. It's now a 5-2 lead for Cincinnati. Amir Garrett comes on looking for a save here in the bottom of the ninth inning. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And up next will be Gavin Lux.
Hey, not impossible, but highly improbable. Even when you're at home to score three runs off a closer like this guy, they've got the work cut out for him.
And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one.
When your closer comes in and strikes out the first guy he faces, everyone on the team can kind of take a deep breath. Still have two more outs to get, but retiring that leadoff guy is always huge when you're trying to shut a game down.
The 3-1. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. And that's in there, base hit. And there's probably no happier person in the ballpark.
Right fielder,
DJ Peters has just collected his first hit in the big leagues. And as is customary, there's the ball being sent into the dugout. Someone will tuck it away for him to put in his trophy case.
Yeah, good for him and congratulations. Listen, he's worked his entire lifetime for this moment, and he's obviously trying to play it cool right now, but you can bet inside his head, he's on top of the world.
Stepping in now, Mookie Betts. A swing and a drive to center field. That one's got a chance. Senzel backing up on it. And that one is gone! Two-run shot to straightaway center. As they pull within one here, it's now a 5-4 game.
That, my friends, is a cardinal sin for any closer. You can't give up the long ball. Good thing for him, he still has the lead. We'll see now if he can rebound and actually keep it.
So now to the plate, Max Muncy. Strike two swinging just out in front of the slider. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan, D-Row, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage.
Yeah, you know, D-Row, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
Sean Doolittle takes over on the mound now as he'll try to get the final out of the ballgame here and pick up a save. The Dodgers down to their final strike. High and deep down the left field line. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Doolittle's ready. Here comes the pitch.
Great take right there, but the last thing you want to do is be called out on strikes to end the game.
Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he lays off a pitch off the plate and high, 3-2.
Time to narrow your focus up there at the plate. In a one-run game, he doesn't want to walk you, so there's a good chance he's going to get something to handle right here.
Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. And he's just going to make him throw as many pitches as he can as he fouls another one away, and it's still full at 3-2. And it's fouled away. Ah, and he strikes him out to end it here as they were able to get the possible tying run to the plate but could not cash in.
Hey, I've given up trying to predict where this amazing streak's going to end, so I'm just going to congratulate them and say, well done.
A one-run finish today, 5-4 the final score. Cincinnati used a nice fifth inning to take the lead, and they never gave it back. Carson Fulmer claimed the win out of the pen, his first. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
The final line score for our ball game this afternoon for the victorious Cincinnati Reds. 5 runs on 5 hits. No errors. They left 7.